hands on your neck, boy. Your head getting lighter. Try to fight me. This grip gets tighter. If I let go, boy, you've got to help me. There's someone out there who helps your family. But you're not gonna say a word.
Mrs. Joe is out to get him, and she's gone out looking for him at least 3 times. He's really worried, and he hides behind the door when Mrs. Joe comes in, but he's soon found.
Why has my life been dealt this wicked blow? Married to a blacksmith with brother brat in tow.
Go easy on the boy, he has so much to learn. A blacksmith's life is hard when there's smithy fires burn.
Brought him up by hand, he'd drive me to my grave.
Poor miserable Pip, orphaned yet so brave.
Pip's slips out later that night. He is full of fear, but he takes the food, drink and fire to the churchyard. On the way, he meets another escaped convict, Scarface, who just runs away. Later that same day, the soldiers come searching for the convicts and catch them both. And as the convict calls them to catch Scarface, where they are wrestling in the mud, the convict sees Pip and tells the officer that he stole the pie and the drink and the files from the blacksmith so that Pip won't get into trouble. Pip never forgets his experiences on the marshes that day. But a year later, completely by surprise, he's invited to visit the wealthy Miss Havisham at Satis House to entertain her and her adopted daughter, Estella. Pip arrives at the gates and is let in by Estella, but Pip is very awkward and drops things during his visit and doesn't quite know how to behave.
I'll show you in, boy, take off your hat. I'll show you in, boy, no, don't touch that. Come along with me, boy, your country oath. Come along with me, boy, have you heard of soap? I'm so pretty and refined. You're far beneath me, you will find. If you follow the golden rules, get along just fine. Don't look at me, and most importantly, don't touch me. Come up the stairs, boy, please hurry back. Come up the stairs, boy, oh what a klutz. Yeah, boy, in you go. It's just in there, boy, don't be so slow. I'm so pretty and refined. You're far beneath me, you will find. If you follow the golden rules, you'll get along just fine. Don't look at me, and most importantly, don't touch me at all.
Pip, through the house, the ramshackled old house, up the dark stairs, in order to meet Miss Havisham. He has never met anybody like her before.
Once upon a time I dared to dream. He came to me and loved me as if it were a dream. And now days and weeks and years mean nothing to me. It's such a tragedy. Get out of my life, nothing has changed. Not even the hands on the clock rearrange. Go back where you came from, I bid you farewell. I hope you burn in hell. Dance with me, nothing's ever quite what it seems. Dance with me in the castle of my broken dreams, like moths around.
look at you now, if I may, and all that life has worn away. Get out of my hair, go off and play. Look but don't touch, a heart will betray. Go back where you came from, I bid you farewell. Your dreams can burn in hell. To make my baying public wait, no sun upon my yellow skin while I'm without him. Get out of my house, it's all just a game. Pocket by nature and pocket by name. Go back where you came from, I bid you farewell. I'd rather a burn in hell. Relations. They seem to be hoping for money. They're known as the Pockets.
Birthday to you. We are your family.
go away and play in the garden while she deals with the pockets. And he goes outside on his own, and while he's out there, he meets a young boy, Herbert Pocket, who challenges him to a fight. watching the fight from the window, and when she shows Pip out, she lets him kiss her on the cheek. Pip is absolutely thrilled by this. And every time he visits again, he hopes for another kiss. Pip's sister, Mrs. Jo, becomes very unwell, and she dies of a fever. And a new housekeeper arrives called Birdie. Pip tells her he wants to become a gentleman. He so wants to become a gentleman. Havisham and Estella as he starts his apprenticeship with Jo at the forge. He goes to say goodbye to Miss Havisham, and at last Estella lets him kiss her again when he leaves. Pip doesn't want to be a blacksmith, but he really has no choice, until one day, as a complete surprise, a lawyer from London, Mr. Jaggers, arrives at the blacksmith's and demands to see Pip and Jo together.
I'm the bearer of an offer to relieve you of this fellow. Would you stand in his way?
I have no objection.
You have a future in a place far from here. What, Mr. Pip, do you say? Young man, we have great expectations of you. We have great expectations of you. A man of great expectations, that's you. You're coming to property, all you desire. A young gentleman, fancy and free. Your destiny beckons in the city of dreams. You'll become what you're meant to be.
No objection.
Young man, we have great expectations of you. Great expectations of you. Because your head is strong, your heart is true. A man of great expectations, that's you. Your benefactor's name will not be revealed. Your suspicions of who it might be must not be expressed, but kept close to your chest. Soon, young man, you'll be free. We have great, great, great expectations of you. Great expectations of you. With your head is strong, your heart is true. A man of great expectations, that's you. So to London town in a week. Buy yourself some clothes and learn how to speak. With 20 years to spend on yourself. Here's to your future and here's to your health, health, health. Great expectations of you. Great expectations of you. Cause your head is strong, your heart is true. A man of great expectations is true. We have great expectations of you. Great expectations of you. With your head is strong, your heart is true. Great expectations of you. A man of great expectations, that's you. A man of great expectations, that's you.
He's absolutely thrilled by this news, and he goes to Miss Havisham to say goodbye. He secretly thinks she is his benefactor, and a little leads him on a little bit. He is sad that Estella is abroad, learning to be a lady. Joe and Birdie see Pip off onto the stagecoach for London.
Journey stars, you're setting out. Farewell to you, dear. We love you still, we'll always be here. Take care and enjoy your trip. What loves you will have, what adventures you'll find. You're broadening your horizons,
you're opening your mind.
What loves you will have, what adventures you'll find.
By his journey into London, he's never been on such a long trip, and he's very, very excited when he sees all the big buildings and people and so on. And as soon as he gets off the stagecoach, he is approached by a prostitute.
Yeah.
from these parts, are you, darling? If you like, I can show you around. You know all the best places, darling. I know all of London town. I can show you a good time, darling. I can give you whatever you need. What about a discount, darling? Just come with me.
Bless me, you're the prowling boy. Welcome to the city, our fighting is all done. How you've changed, fortune fits you well. Alas, I've been failed to please Miss Havisham. As time passed, I understood. No varnish can hide the grain of the wood. No varnish can hide the grain of the wood. Stella is a Tartar, wouldn't you agree? Haughty and capricious to the last degree. To hold your own in smart society, it's well to do as other people do. Look about, don't overfill your mouth. We'll get on famously, I'll raise my glass to you. Just be sure that you understand. No varnish can hide the grain of the wood. No varnish can hide the grain of the wood. No varnish can hide the grain of the wood.
And spends more than his income, having lots of parties and visitors and guests and all sorts. And when he reaches the age of 21, he visits Mr. Jaggers again.
You know you won't inherit a thing now, Pip. The money will go to the crown. And if there were a child, they might get it, Pip. But there's no child to be found. But there was a child, I know it. There was a child, you know it too. Do the right thing, admit it, Mr. Jaggers, I beg of you. I'm gonna put a kiss to you, Pip. But naturally I make no admission. So I'm being hypothetical, legal and collective. And there, dear Pip, is my submission. I'm gonna put a case to you, Pip. There's a woman that was charged with murder. I'm gonna put a case that the woman had a child and the father had a convict. Further, I'm gonna get a case, Pip. at the woman's legal advisor, who's a very rich lady who can never have a baby and is anxious to adopt a little girl. I'm gonna put a case to you, Pip, that Molly, my maid, is a mother to a woman out of reach who you keep. To a woman out of reach who you love like no other, but you have to keep it strictly undercover. Well, Pip.
If I'm in my right mind and that woman is Estella's mother, this legal advisor you mentioned will have a lot to answer for.
I see barefoot boys in rags in the street, little girls begging for something to eat. I see children tried in the criminal bar, imprisoned, neglected, but worse by far. I see the rich getting richer, the poor getting hanged for tiny misdemeanors that we could all understand. And I make an admission. It hurts me. That's my admission. It makes me cry. And yes, I have a mission. I admit it, but it gives me a reason why. When I can help one little girl or boy sleep a little better at night, I can wash my hands a little less and feel like I did a little right. Like I did a little right. Did a little light, like I did something right.
Yeah. Pip hears that Joe Gargery is coming to visit him in London, and Pip is not keen on this as an idea, and is even less keen when Joe arrives. Pip has become a snob, and the city has corrupted him.
I'm a gentleman, that's me. I go to luncheon, maybe for a drink of free. People, they get jealous of my finery when I go mincing by. With my nose up, disappear beneath the kitchen floor. Look at his outfit, for Pete's sake. He drops his hat and the tea and cake. Thank goodness he's not staying long. This sight of him just makes my belly ache. Your dungarees, but maybe he's feeling lonely. Maybe I should feel some shame. Maybe he
goes off home. One evening, on a very wet night, in his rooms, Pip is surprised by a knock on the door. It is the convict, but Pip doesn't recognise him at first. He doesn't really want to let him into his room.
You're only but a young boy when the two of us first met. I was desperate, you showed mercy that I never did forget. I'd lost my faith in others, barely could tell the right from wrong. Then you risked it all to help me. I found strength to carry on. Since you walked into my life, I've known what I must do. Work each hour the day since. As I sat upon the galleys, in my chains I turned to plants, till my heart nearly split open, as my feet scorched on the sand. They had sent me over the ocean, to work in Van Diemen's land. Even though they couldn't stop me, let my willpower make a stand. Since you walked into my life, I have known what I must do. Work each hour the day since. Earn a life for you. I just to show you what your kind heart inspired me to do. And you all want for nothing. Oh, shit, sorry. And you all want for nothing. I owe nothing in return. 'Cause my son, you gave me purpose to survive to hold.
Is a wanted man and has to leave the country or he'll be arrested. Pip decides to help him escape and plans to go with him. He has to visit Miss Havisham and Estella to say goodbye, so he sets off for Satis House. He finds Miss Havisham in her room.
Get out of here, or I'll tear you apart. My plan for the girl was to break many hearts. Go back where you came from, I bid you farewell. 'Cause I will burn in hell. still love my broken dreams, like moths around the flame. You just keep coming back again. Whatever your motive might be, dance with me.
The mysterious person that Miss Havisham might one day have married long, long, long ago has a voice and wishes to be heard.
I'm no stranger. I'm being myself again. Do me a favor. Read my note and I'll explain how much you mean to me. You've not answered. Are you dining out with all your friends? And are you dancing? Are your arms round someone else? And if so, where does that leave me? I've been drowning, sinking deeper than you can imagine. You had me flying, soaring higher than I've ever been. There's no reason to write such bitter words. Yes, I'll be faithful. Wedding vows are for better or worse. Money or your land? You think I'd give a damn? Then you can't have me as a man. I've been drowning, sinking deeper than you could imagine. I've just crumbled. I can't believe you've been so mean. Please forgive me. There is nothing more that I can say. But rest assured, there will never be a day that you'll ask yourself again. Did I do wrong?
Manages to see Estella and to tell her how much he has loved her for ever and ever, ever since he first met her. But she is not at all interested in him and turns away and explains that she will never marry him.
No one told you I would love you back. Never said that I could care. Tried to warn you not to love. I haven't got a heart.
Drummle, who's a young man from London, who's very wealthy and goes out hunting and all of these things that real gentlemen do.
Plays in a rock band.
Plays in a rock band, yeah. Comes on Avon courses and so on and so on.
Something to discuss.
boat to the continent. They make their escape from London by rowing boat that evening, but are seen by Scarface, who has been following Pip and the convict in order to get his revenge. Scarface is not going to let them get away.
You won't like what I gotta say, 'cause today is your last day. They always say revenge is sweet. See the day you dame my queen. Gonna get you, I'm gonna get you now. I've been waiting, just hanging around. It's no disguise that I haven't spied. Why don't you just go and hide? Gonna get you now. What you've done, gonna get you, gonna get you now. I've been waiting, just hanging around. There's no disguise that I haven't spied. Don't you go and hide. Gonna get you now. My conscience, no moral code. I always take the easy road. It's me or you's got to die. I don't mind telling a few lies. It's gonna get you now. Gonna get you, gonna get you now. I've been waiting, just hanging around. There's no disguise that I haven't spied. Get you now, get you now, gonna get you now, gonna get you now, gonna get you now.
The convict tried to intercept the packet boat, but a police boat with Scarface on board pursues them and crashes into their dinghy. The convict is caught and sent for trial. He and many other prisoners are in the courtroom waiting to be sentenced.
It was only a mistake. How did I end up? To be here, I'm weary and I'm old.
God bless my children, they're hungry and they're cold.
We are the poor, the ones who clean and fetch. We are the beggars, the ones who haven't met. We are the hungry with no money to feed ourselves. We are the ones you have to blame for all your ills. They want to get rid of us, it's perfectly clear. Our lives have been one long struggle and fight. How can they judge us when they know where we live? Why can't they see this is just our life? The judge is looking serious, he's getting on his back. Saying something, my heart is pounding fast.
we are to be taken from here and hanged until we die. But we're not the real villains. It's they who will lie and cry. We are the poor.
Hospital. Pip visits Jaggers to see if his benefactor can be saved, but Jaggers just confirms that no one will inherit when he dies, however he dies, and all the money will go to the crown unless there is a true child. And there is one, Miss Estella. Mr. Jaggers reveals why he's behaved in the way he has.
I see barefoot boys in rags in the street, little girls begging for something to eat. I see children tried at the criminal bar, imprisoned and neglected. Worse by far. I see the rich getting richer, the poor getting hanged for tiny misdemeanors we can easily understand. I'll make an admission. It hurts me. This is my admission. It makes me cry. And yes, I have a mission, I admit it. It gives me the reason why. And I help one little girl or boy sleep a little better at night. I wash my hands just a little bit less, and I feel I did a little right. I did a little right. Did a little right. Did a little right.
Mr. Jaggers asks his housekeeper to take an appearance. Pip realises that she looks very, very much like Estella. Her name is Molly.
I know what you're thinking. Did she kill him? I'll tell you now, I did. Ladies, you know how men are. That prick pushed too far. That is why I did. I did. I pushed that bastard down. Then I met Magwitch, that son of a bitch. He promised me, he lied. He took it too far, you know how men are. That's why the judge, he sent that bastard down. You think I'm a wild thing tame, you think I'm punished and I'm shamed. Yes, I know that I'm to blame, but all I have to say is you get by the best you can. I was a pretty little thing, my hair was thick, my waist was thin. You meet a man, but that's a different story. You meet a man, but that's another story. You think that I was wild and tamed. You think I'm punished and ashamed. Yes, I know that I'm to blame, to say is you get by as best you can. And what of the child? My sweet fatherless child, with cops and hunger knocking at our door. So many babies starving around me, of course, I gave my bastard away. You think that I'm a wild thing tamed, you think I'm punished and ashamed. Yes, I know that I'm to blame, but all I have to say is you get by any way you can. And where is my child? When I think of my child, I want to throw myself away.
Pip visits his benefactor in the prison hospital and tells him his child is alive and that he loves her. Magwitch dies almost straight after receiving this news. And then Pip becomes very ill, and Joe arrives and takes him home to care for him in the countryside.
Tuesday, hear the church clock chime. I brought you home to nurse you back to your full health. There's so much more in this life than chasing after wealth. So be still, rest easy. Take one day at a time. Go and find your lady. It's your time to shine.
Satis house. It's up for sale. He pushes the door open and finds Estella sitting there. She's not going to marry Bentley, as he was so shocked to hear who her father was, a convict. She wants to spend the rest of her days at Satis House, buying it with the inheritance she got from her convict father. Pip refuses to accept this and pulls down the curtains and opens the shutters to let the light in.
When you come near, 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 fill my heart here, here, here. You touch me there.